Novias at home, you are welcome again on our daily devotional on Golf TV. This is another day that the Lord has made and will greatly rejoice in His presence. You are blessed. Before we set out for today, let's quickly examine the Word of God. And before we go into the Word, let us pray. Father, we thank you for today. Thank you for the Word that we'll be observing. Teach us your Word. In Jesus' name, and give our hearts understanding to read. In Jesus' name, for in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We are at home. If you have been following us, you know we're in lesson 12. And if you have been observing your lesson, we started right from lesson 1. God has given us the grace to take our lesson 12 today. And by the grace of God, we have the general topic that says Moses. His ultimate glory. Moses is ultimate glory. We have the topic for the adult that says glorious ending. God will give us glorious ending in Jesus' name. And for the youth, says impart your generation positively. And why for the intermediate, says a glorious future is ahead. Praise the Lord. We have a memory verse also that is taken from Hebrew. Chapter 11, verses 24-25. By the grace of God, today, Sunday, 22nd of November 2015, we'll be taking a very good topic, a great topic, that will end this lesson. And it is taken from Hebrew, that is our text, it's taken from Hebrew, chapter 11, verses 23-29. I've told you earlier, we have a very good topic ahead of us. It says, what will you be remembered for? A great question. A great question. What will you be remembered for? Everybody have to ponder on that question. What will you be remembered for? As I've told you earlier, our text is taken from Hebrew chapter 11, verses 23-29. By the grace of God, I will be reading from New Living Translation Version. Follow me as I continue to read. It was by faith that Moses' parents hid him for 3 months when he was born. They saw that God has given them an unusual child, and they were not afraid to disobey their king's command. It was by faith that Moses, when he grew up, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose to share the oppression of God's people. Instead of enjoying the fleeting pleasure of sin, he thought it was better to suffer for the sake of Christ than to own the treasure of Egypt, for he was looking ahead of his great reward. It was by faith that Moses left the land of Egypt, not fearing the king's anger. He kept right on going because he kept his faith, he kept his eyes on the one who is invisible. It was by faith that Moses commanded the people of Israel to keep the Passover and to sprinkle blood on the doorpost so that the angel of death will not kill their firstborn sons. It was by faith that the people of Israel went right through the Red Sea as though they were on the dry ground. But when the Egyptians tried to follow, they were all drowned. What will you be remembered for? Viewers at home, what will you be remembered for? If you look at the lineage of Moses, right from his birth to how he was commissioned to lead the people of Israel out of Egypt. Everything he did was an act of faith. He did everything in an act of faith. Viewers at home, do you know our daily living life is of faith? Our eating is due to faith. Our going out, we do it in faith. That is what really helped Moses. He did everything. He left the pleasure of Egypt because of faith. He believed that God has a good plan for him. Viewers at home, Moses surrendered everything he has for the sake of the children of Israel. He surrendered everything. He didn't even have anything in his custody again. He surrendered them. He laid down his life for the children of Israel. Viewers at home, what will you be remembered for? Even you parents at home, what will your children remember you for? Do you know, your record may not be read when you are still alive. It will be read immediately you pass on. What will they read about you? Do you know that something you have to know? See, you never make it to make a positive impact. You will be making a negative impact. Because the life of sin is the life that God did not reckon for. Reckon with. God did not want the life of sin. Therefore, you have to forsake your sin and begin to live a positive life so that you can have a positive impact. And do you know, if you have a positive impact, you have a reward for it. You have a reward for it. You may be suffering for the impact you are making now, but at the same time, you have a reward. What impact are you making? Even you youth at home, when you come home for your holiday, are you having any impact at home? If you have not been doing so, it is better you adjust your life now so that you can have a positive impact and you have a great reward ahead of you. God bless you. Before you close for this lesson, we have our point of emphasis that says, Moses gave his all to God and his generation. He gave all his all to God and to his generation. Are you laying down your life for your generation or the next generation that is coming? They will need your own record. God will help you in Jesus' name. Let's take our prayer points. Lord, let my generation and incoming generation praise your name through my life in Jesus' name. Lord, I declare for all the viewers at home the grace and the power to start making an impact for our generation. Give it to us in Jesus' name. Thank you because you are God. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Viewers at home, I know you have really enjoyed the presence of God today, and God has richly blessed you. God bless you in Jesus' name. I want to tell you, starting from tomorrow, we will be observing our sharing and admonition. Join us tomorrow for all your questions. Answer will be supplied. God bless you in Jesus' name.